This territory, known popularly as the Saar Enclave, is made up of Santrokofi, Akpafu, Likpe, and Lolobi. The area used to be part of the Hohe municipality until December 27, 2018, when six new administrative regions were created in Ghana. This area then became part of the newly created Oti region, which also meant that the Saar Enclave was effectively no longer part of the Hohe municipality where it belonged before the December 27, 2018 referendum. Madam Felicia Oye, who lives in Santrokofi, tells City News the staff of waste management company Zoom Lion Ghana Limited were the first to feel the impact of the breakaway of the Saar Enclave from the Hohe municipality. A former assembly member for Santrokofi Bodume and opinion leader Matthias Chaku Ayim says the creation of the new region has not brought with it the development for which it was demanded.
Matter of fact, we are agitating for a region with a purpose. We've had the region, but the purpose has not been achieved. Why do I say that? I say that because we're agitating for a district. And it appears that our agitation is being denied now. And that denial comes in the wake of a whole lot of things. First, we are being denied our national cake. The district's share of the common fund, because we haven't had the district, that has not come. So we don't know where we belong now. Secondly, we don't even have a parliamentarian, no MP. And we are being denied our franchise, where that is involved. Because we're going to vote this year. Who is going to be our parliamentarian? We don't have that parliamentarian. Who is going to fight for us?
The community has its dilapidated school blocks and the lack of other amenities as evidence of the inequalities the area suffers. Physically challenged persons who ordinarily accessed support from a share of the district assembly's common fund have all been left to their fate. The assembly member for Santrokofi, Philip Adom, says he feels helpless with the numerous challenges the community faces.
Well, I must admit, like anybody else, I mean, you can't actually install a king or a chief without a palace. Unfortunately, this is what I have come to meet. I mean, being a first-time assembly member, when you look at the circumstances surrounding my election, that tells you clearly that the people want something, or there is something they see or believe that such a young person like myself can offer them. Unfortunately, this has been confronted with so many challenges. I mean, for instance, like any other assembly, they have a common fund. Unfortunately, we do not have. So it makes it very, very difficult and challenging to come to terms with. For instance, we have an issue with water crisis. During the drought, I mean, earlier in the year, we were rationing water. So amidst the COVID, whilst they were even giving PPs and stuff, we didn't benefit from anything. Because which assembly are you going to take these things from? That notwithstanding, we have issues with, for instance, the school building you just actually saw, that is also in bad shape. After the election, earlier in the year, the Oti regional minister was here. He made mention of Honorable Teddy Ofori, the Hohe municipal chief executive, being the caretaker in our area. But unfortunately, we haven't seen much of him here.
Santrokofi also lies along the Eastern Corridor Road, and the driver of the taxi I boarded insisted on sending a message to the presidential candidates of the two leading political parties.
We are pleading Mahama and Akufo-Addo, the two of them, they are our fathers. They are our boss, our God. So we are pleading the two of them. If maybe Mahama win or Akufo-Addo win, they started doing some job at them. They should try, they should try and continue. No, the money is for Ghana, it's not for them.
At Lolobi Ashambi as well, I was greeted by roads with very deep potholes. I am told that at least three vehicles break down on this road on daily basis and are often left to become death traps like this bus, which they say has been here for over a year. The assembly member for Lolobi Ashambi says they have expectations of the yet to be established Gwan or SAL assembly.
What we are seeking is a lot. We're seeking in terms of education, we're seeking in terms of roads, seeking in terms of healthcare, in terms of water. We are seeking a lot. Prior to the creation of the OT region, we were all under Hohwe constituency, that is the SAL enclave, which is today proposed Gwan district. We had been receiving some kind of help or attention from the Hohwe municipality, but since the creation of the OT region, the attentions had waned, they had gone down.
An opinion leader at Lolobi, Pascal Benson Atigla, tells City News the establishment of the assembly in Lolobi will make life for the enclave easier.
The primary reason why we need a district is to ensure that the development that we ask for, we get it. So as we'll be able to mobilize the resources that there are for our developmental purpose, like the roads, the schools, among other things. And we think that the district capital, we want it here in Lolobi, not just because of the ego or the selfish interest, but we think that it is going to serve the interests of the neighboring traditional areas. Likpe is closer to us, Santrogofi is closer to us, and we think Akpafutu is closer to us. We are the middle. In fact, so central that no other traditional area can say that they are more central than we are. So in terms of converging for administrative purposes, in terms of resources, cocoa and other, in terms of rice, Lolobi is a big community that produces local and brown rice. And I think that with this, and the traditional culture that we have, the festivals that we celebrate, I think that when we put the district capital in Lolobi here, it is going to be an area we can all rally around for the development that we need in the Gwan proposed district, the purpose for which we are asking for the district capital.
Residents in the enclave, popularly known as SAL, Santrogofi, Akpafu, Likpe and Lolobi, are hoping that with the advent of their district, situations like this, which is a classroom block, will be rectified as their district development fund would provide some funding for some of those challenges within the area. They are also pleading with the government to come to their aid in demarcating a constituency for them so that they may also have a representation in parliament. Reporting for City News, my name is Benjamin Aklama from Santrogofi in the Oti region of Ghana.